Hey friends, it's Azure Friday. I'm here with Kirill, and we're going to talk a little bit more about Azure Cosmos DB, some of the exciting new features like Cassandra support. How's it going?
Awesome. It's always such a pleasure to be here. Thank you for having me. Today is especially exciting because at the end of the year, lots of good things came out that we announced just a couple weeks ago. And one of them was availability of Cassandra API on Cosmos DB. Mm-hmm. So as many of you know, Cosmos DB is a globally distributed database with multimodal support. So it allows you to work with multiple different things. For example, with documents using SQL or MongoDB API, with graphs using Redmond API, working with key value pairs using Azure Table API. And now it offers you Cassandra API. And it's Cassandra support for Cassandra API at the protocol level. So you can take your existing app or existing tool sets that you use with Cassandra and just redirect it, point it to Cosmos DB, and they will not know the difference.
So Cassandra is an open source database that people run on Linux VMs on their own?
Yep, good point. It's a very popular, very cool open source database for high scale real-time data scenarios, which is what we're especially excited about because it's exactly what Cosmos DB is for as well.
Right.
We love Cassandra. The main thing, it's an open source database, so if you run it, you have to run it and manage it. You have to, and it's usually used for high-scale scenarios where you're managing large clusters. Mm-hmm. It's a non-trivial investment of DevOps, of your time.
Right.
It's a pretty complicated thing to configure. So we just try to help and take this pain out of.
Couldn't Azure have made a Cassandra database as a service?
Good question. Yes, we could have. We had two options. We could take Cassandra open source and run it as a service, just like we do Redis as a service, right, in Azure. And it's a good approach. The challenge with that approach is that, not really a challenge, but that we thought that we could do better. And by better, meaning that we're not saying that we can do, you know, write better code than open source community. Open source community wrote phenomenal code. But we can do services that are more optimized for Azure. And we have been investing in a particular service called Azure Cosmos DB that brings you global distribution, that brings you multiple consistency, intuitive consistency choices. It brings you super low latency, high scale, and it's a managed service on Azure, optimized for Azure platform. It's aware of the fact that it runs on Azure, as opposed to Cassandra that is written as a Linux, is a database runs on Linux. It doesn't know whether it runs on AWS.
It runs in a VM. It doesn't care if it's in the cloud.
Yeah,
so then that means that you're going to get all of the benefits of the what's good about Cassandra and all of the benefits of being in Azure and knowing you're in Azure.
Yes, that is our goal with this. So let's do a quick demo. So you can create a Cosmos DB with Cassandra API by just going and clicking Create and choosing a Cassandra API.
Okay.
I have already created one because it takes few seconds, close to a minute, to create an account.
All right.
I have created this one, and it's an empty account, as we can see. It doesn't have anything. We open Data Explorer. There are no Cassandra tables. You have a nice quick starts. I'm pretty proud of the quick starts. It speeds up. It answers you a lot of questions. Many people use them. And we use the same technique for Cassandra API. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to communicate to this service, to this database, using Cassandra SQL shell. That's a command line utility that's very common among Cassandra developers. It allows them to do data management operations, insert data, all from command line.
And this shell doesn't know about Azure. It
Absolutely.
Doesn't know that it's not talking to Cassandra.
Exactly. Yep.
Because it is. It's talking to Cassandra on Cosmos.
Let's see what it will do. So let's copy this line. Let's go. So here I'm running Python and I'm running SQL SHPY, which
so
is a SQL shell.
SQL shell is a Python app.
It's a Python app.
All right.
And then this will connect SQL shell to Cosmos DB account with Cassandra API. And again, it thinks that it's connected to a prod cluster at some host name. That's all it knows, right? It thinks that it's Cassandra.
And it says right there, native protocol V4. For all it knows, it's talking to Cassandra.
Yep. So let's do a few SQL. SQL is Cassandra query language, very similar to SQL. I think it's a subset of SQL with few additional. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a key space equivalent of a database. Mm-hmm. Create a key space. We'll create a table in that key space, and we'll insert few entry points, effectively the videos that we're recording today. We can just copy paste this, okay. And in SQL Shell, we'll insert them one by one. And again, it doesn't know anything about Cosmos DB. It just keeps executing Cassandra query language commands.
Is Cassandra a more SQL-like or more Mongo-like?
It's neither. It's effectively a wide column family database.
Okay.
So it's good at operating with the flat rows.
Yeah.
You can have as many columns as you like. You have, it's similar to SQL in a sense that it has schema. Mm-hmm. It's not a schemaless database.
Right.
It has a schema, so tables have schemas. And ironically, it's Cosmos DB actually, in this case, serves you a schema.
Right.
But the only thing is you can change it anytime in the back. The other thing is that we index everything, so you don't have to worry about indexing. It doesn't really matter what I specify here as to be indexed. Everything will get indexed.
Yep.
So let's go back to our Data Explorer. So as we can see, now we have it created Azure Friday key space and videos collection. And now if we click on rows, we should see the rows that get inserted by SQL Shell.
Mm-hmm.
This kind of completes the round trip. So you can work with, if you prefer a graphic UI interface, you are welcome to work with your Cassandra data from the portal. We offer you a reasonable, nice Data Explorer. Or you can work with your existing tools that you love. And you can take any app and redirect to, just like we redirect the SQL Shell, you can redirect an app at Cosmos DB just by changing a connection string.
Sometimes with these databases like Mongo, as an example, there are niche or more obscure features. So when you initially came out with your Mongo support, you supported like 80% of what Mongo supports. How does that work in the Cassandra space? Could I plug my Cassandra app in and find out that maybe there's a feature that you don't support?
Definitely right now. We're in preview.
Okay.
So there are certain, we don't support certain data types, which we're adding.
Mm-hmm.
There are certain constructs of SQL language that currently we don't map to.
Okay.
But the good news is that we've done a pretty thorough analysis of Cassandra API, and there is nothing that we cannot support.
Nice.
In some sense, it's actually easier than Mongo. Because Mongo is a very sophisticated data model, lots of features and tools. Mongo always focused on making it developer friendly.
Mm-hmm.
So as a result, they satisfied as many asks as possible.
Right, they did everything.
Right.
And the kitchen
With
set.
Cassandra, it's optimized for perf, which we're already pretty good at. The data model is much simpler.
Cool. So it sounds like people should be using this in preview now, trying it out, and seeing if their Cassandra apps work great and seeing what the performance characteristics are.
Yep, and we'll keep working on it, and in some time, we'll deliver 100% compat.
That's fantastic, and it sounds like you're pretty excited about the compatibility that you have today.
Yes, it's preview. It's just like when we went with Mongo. 80% mm-hmm. is probably an accurate number.
Yeah, that's great. And so it's in preview now, people can try it out, and then as you start to have more confidence in it, you'll eventually go GA, and it'll be available for everyone. Fantastic. All right. I'm learning all about how you can do a Cassandra database on top of Azure Cosmos DB with the new Cassandra DB APIs here on Azure Friday.